Misery Club.
Hour and a half long Goth Boy Click classic DJ set. It's on my SoundCloud now. What's up, Lilia? What's up, Shameless? What's up, Scott? What's up, Jenna? Danny? Sailor Gemini, that's old Zubin. It's called Somebody Else. Let me see if I can find it. I think this is it. Yeah, here. I'll put it on. Here's. I'll put it, the link in the. I feel like that's a very long link. That's John Simmons' favorite Zubin song. What's up, Ruby? I'm home right now. What's up, AJ? What's up, Noel? Who'd I miss? Tinseltown, thank you, thank you, thank you. What's up, Kushia? I am dropping new music this Friday. Wicked Face Springs Eternal, the moon does reflect off the shores of forgiveness. Featuring Doves. Produced by Forever. The moon does reflect off the shores of forgiveness. What's my favorite Zubin song? Question. I think his best work is the stuff that we did on the Surrender EP. I'm not saying that his best songs are with me. I'm just saying that some of my favorite stuff he did is on there. His part, him and Jonah going back and forth on Surrender. His part on Lake is good. His part on Lights Out is great. And I like, I love that new Isolate EP. Shameless, are you just casually dropping that you're engaged? What? What? Okay. I missed a chapter when? Between Sunday and Tuesday? Congratulations. Wow, congratulations. Where was I? I was probably off on, you know, off in Full Moon Mystery Garden. Oh, my favorite Zubin song is the IDWGT or whatever. I don't want to go there. Thanks, Mall SWAT. Sometimes I think, oh, Mincanta, thank you, thank you. Wow, congratulations, Shameless. Gorilla, what did you do? Here's the deal. You don't get banned from the Discord server without, you know. Goofiness does not get you banned. Favorite Suicide Boy song? Couldn't name a single one. Couldn't do it. I have no idea. Would I DJ a wedding? Maybe. I'm not hitting on Suicide Boys. I just never listen to them. But yeah, you gotta do something crazy. Not crazy, but listen, the people who have been banned from the Discord have like been like stalking people or smoking meth on there or something, like, you know. And I'm not banning people. I put that in the hands of people that I trust more than myself to do that. Noel, Taylor, Ian. I don't know who else. Can you list me as a reference on your application? Yes. Goofing around. I would love to know what you were goofing around about. I'm curious now. I gotta check. I haven't been on Discord today. You've always been curious what my opinion of Jim Cornette is. I think he's, you know, he has I don't know. He's too aggressive. I'll say that. I'm sure he's smarter. Sure, he's smarter than a lot of wrestling fans, but he acts like an idiot sometimes, you know? You must say, Forgive Me is such a beautiful song. What song is Forgive Me? Oh, the Fish and Arc one. Yeah. Thank you. What's my favorite coffee? Just like a black coffee. Am I ever going to bring back that super muffled vocal style? I don't know. Turns more people off than it does get me new fans. What, I'm just answering questions now? Is that what we're doing? What's your face, Prince Journal? God, boy, click. Misery Club. Full Moon Mystery Garden. The moon does reflect off the shores of forgiveness. Where's Taylor? Oh my God. Listen, if you guys have questions, here, put them here. Go there. Go to the open forum. Ooh, we're boosting. All right, though. Yes, the moon does reflect off the shores of forgiveness. New mixtape. 11-4. As long as the artwork comes back tomorrow. The masters came back yesterday. Taylor is on vacation. You're right. I got the masters back. I don't need to reset. I'm fine. Full Ruby got it right. Jonah got it right. Full Moon Mystery Garden. November 4th, I think. 20 songs. That ain't Shameless. 20 songs. Hey, thanks, Dave. What's up, Dave? November 4th. If you have questions, put them in the open forum. I'll get to them later. And it's anonymous, so I won't get annoyed if you ask a million of them. I'm just kidding. I'm sorry. Also, if you want to be goofy in the Discord, there's the link. You want to hear a song? Oh, yeah. Clusk, you're right. You're right. Thanks, Tinseltown. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, you're right, Clusk. That was a reset. You're right. You want... what can I play? You've heard three of the songs already. They're out. Forbidden Door, Aura, Tracer are out. So you've heard those. I've leaked some other ones. Sure, I'll play it. Let me think. What would be a good one to play? Thanks, Lelio. Twenty songs total. Is I'll Be the Fire on it? No, that's from NetArb's tape. Album. Will the album versions of the songs be different than the singles? They'll be mastered differently, but that's about it. No, they probably won't. They won't. They probably won't. No, they'll sound the same probably. Can I leak the track list? Next week I'll do that. Or no, I'll do it like maybe next week, maybe the week after. But I will, I'm not going to leak it right now. I can tell you the names, but I can't tell you who's on what songs. Here's the track list. Ready? Number one, I named all these songs today. 11-4, November 4th, 3 weeks from now. Full Moon, Mystery Garden, Wicked Phase, Springs Eternal. Track one, Dark Region Road. Track two, Mine is a Curious Passage. Track three, I'll Return to the Land. Track four, I Am the Edge. Track five, Hickory Grove. Yeah, Dark Region Road. Is that one, Danny? R-E-G-I-O-N. Track five, Hickory Grove. Track six, On a Mountain Under Full Moon. Track seven, Tonight I'm in Love on My Own. Track eight, I Was on a Back Road by Myself. Track nine, House at the River's Bend. Track 10, Tumblr Moon. Track 11, I See the Moon and See a Meaning. Track 12, Forbidden Door. Track 13, It's the Chaos from a Hard Time. Track 14, Tracer. Track 15, Vocal Trance Playlist. Track 16, I Am the Same. Track 17, I've Been Staying Up Late Again. Track 18, Actual. Like factual, but without the F. Actual. Track 19, The Moon Does Reflect Off the Shores of Forgiveness, which is coming out this Friday. Track 20, Aura. Whew. How about I play... I'll play I See the Moon and See a Meaning. How about that? I'm going to play the song that's coming out on Friday on Thursday. How about that? Here we go. Will this have to be a 2LP vinyl? Well, it's not. It's just a digital release. I See the Moon and See a Meaning, produced by who? Brody and Rem Ghost. Brody and Rem Ghost together have the two of them have produced four or five songs. My sheet is kind of hard to read. Anyway, here's a song. By the way, I'm going on tour. What's up, Marcus? I'm going on tour. December 6th, starting in Phoenix. Oh, yeah, I should do that shameless. You're right. Let me do that quick. I'll do that while I'm playing a song. Anyway, here's a new song. All right, called I See the Moon and See a Meaning, produced by Brody and Rem Ghost. Full Moon Mystery Garden. November 4th. Next single, this Friday. In the meantime, I see the moon and see a meaning.
Hello and welcome to the garden.
The five boroughs I'm known. Forget about it.
Baby, I am the mountain you can see. The forest and its trees. The shadow.
A lot of fun in the garden. Misery.
Stay out of your way.
Click.
Wicked Face, Prince Eternal. Goth Boy, Click, Misery Club. Full Moon Mystery Garden, November 4th. Thanks, everyone. That is mixed, not mastered. Thanks, everyone. How would I feel about someone bootlegging some of my digital album only albums onto vinyl? Would I be flattered or pissed? I wouldn't be thrilled with it. Like, I mean, for yourself, it's fine. I'd be fine if you did it for yourself. Yeah, solo copy's fine. Thanks, everyone. Yeah, Marcus, you could, I think you could just get a single record pressed. I think there's ways to do it. Is there any business reason why some artists combine all the singles on Spotify into a mini EP rather than all separate? Notice yours are separate. Hey, thanks, Panopticon. I don't know. I think some people do it. I remember Turnstile did it when they were releasing singles from their newest album. They were like kind of putting them, or I forget. I don't know. I actually don't know what the benefit is. I think the only thing I could think of offhand is like, well, then you get people listening to a bunch of songs in a row rather than you listening to one of my songs, and then all of a sudden you're listening, you know, Spotify sends you over to Brennan Savage's page or something like that, you know. Yeah, right, Cloves. I think, it's in case people miss the last song. Yeah, and it bumps it up. Mm-hmm. Am I entitled? Yes. Can you pre-order the mixtape? Well, it's just a digital thing. But yeah, there will probably be a pre-save link. I don't really know what the deal is with those. Like, maybe they help the artist? I don't know. I always see people promoting it. I don't know if that's supposed to, like, signal to Spotify, like, ooh, people are interested in this, you should put it on a playlist. I don't know. Yeah, I don't think it would do much. Shameless, I'm very curious to know who your ex is. I saw your tweet about there not being much crossover, any crossover. Between friend groups or whatever, but, you know. Ruby, sometimes I feel like I'm not. Oh, yeah, I don't know who that is. Shameless, I'm sorry. No idea who that is. I mean, I know of the artist, but I've never met him or anything, and I don't know who his friends are. That's what I mean. Did I ever get into watching old school ECW? Sometimes I will watch, like, yeah, sometimes I'm interested in, like, I'll be like, oh, like, what was Dean Malenko's run in ECW like? And I'll watch that. I'll watch, like, a bunch of matches there. Or, like, yeah, like that, you know? WWF No Mercy stream. I don't have a capability of streaming games right now, unfortunately. Thanks, Bloody. What's up? Welcome back, Bloody Killer. Welcome back. Big day. Shameless got engaged. Thanks, Noel. Thank you. Shameless got engaged. Bloody Killer's back. Just leaked a new song. The moon does reflect off the shores of forgiveness. Comes out on Friday. And it's Tinseltown. What's the favorite song you made? I don't know. I like that last one that I just played. What's up, Odlow? How do I feel about the current state of... Why am I doing this? If you have questions, go to the open forum. Ask them there. I'll get to it, I promise. How do you feel about the current state on underground rap? I feel like nobody wants to collaborate and help each other out anymore. It's more about money rather than music and creating something amazing. I don't know. I feel like I don't know. Just go to the open forum. If you have questions, go to the open forum. I'll get to them at the end of the stream. I promise. It's hard because my nature is like, people want to know stuff. I know the answer, or they want to know what I think about something, so I owe it to, you know. Then I get distracted. Frank, what's my opinion on the open forum? I'll tell you this. I like the open forum. I know some people don't like the open forum. I like it. It's fun for me to go there and see crazy stuff. Not crazy stuff, but just to be surprised and not be able to anticipate what I'm going to see there. Now, last week, maybe it would have been last Thursday, someone was being really annoying in it. Really annoying. And if that person is here now, I'm sure they know who they are. Don't be annoying. Like, if you're like trying to troll me, I'm not going to answer. I'm not going to get into it. It was just like the same question over and over. And it was like, just like stupid and immature. And like, you know, I'm like, listen, in doing this, No, it wasn't about Peep. No, it was just like stupid and childish and like immature. And it's like, all right, you come here. My initial hesitancy with streaming was like, you know, I'm like naturally awkward a lot of times and like goofy sometimes. And goofiness is not... a part of myself that I try and make a part of the brand, but for the sake of the stream, like, you'll get some of it just because it comes out, because it's like me in front of a microphone and like I have no choice but to be myself, or else it's, you know, whatever. But that doesn't mean that all, like, yeah, right, goofy, right, yeah, goofy. So that's what I'm getting at, Noelle. Goofiness doesn't mean immaturity, right? It's not like I'm going to come here and just like be like, oh, okay, well, you know, you want me to tread into this territory. I guess I owe it to you because you're watching my stream. It's not like that. Everyone here is fine. Everyone here is like totally cool. And then, like, you know, once a month, someone has to be, like, put in their place. And I'm, so this is me putting that person in their place, all right? Just, like, don't be annoying. They asked, if you want to know, I don't know who it was because the open forum is anonymous, but I can tell you that they asked at, it would have been on October 6th at 7:52:49 Eastern time. Okay. Watch that person. You know I'm going to know who that person was because they're going to get real quiet. And listen, I'm not, you don't have to worry. You don't have to worry. Ravinger, you're right. You don't have to worry about it being you or not being you. Like, this person knows. This person knows that they were just like being obnoxious. You know what I mean? You're fine. It's not, if you're asking real questions or anything like that, you're totally fine. Yeah, it doesn't send... Well, Panopticon, that's right. But this person does know who it was. You know what I mean? I'm not going to get into it. I'm not going to give them the time of day. I'm just saying, don't be fucking annoying, okay? You guys want to see some merch? It was at... I'll tell you the exact timestamp. No, fuck it. I'll just show you some merch. Okay. No, shameless. It definitely wasn't you. They asked this question 15 times. Okay, so if you, like, in with different phrasing, it wasn't like it was like a it wasn't like it was like one thing that like accidentally glitched, and like it accidentally sent like it was like the same thing phrased different ways 15 to 20 times. So, you know. Yeah, you guys know, okay? Who would do that? I don't know. Someone who, you know, I don't know. All right, how can I show you this merch? What is a good way to... Frank. Well, Bedford Towers took some pictures for me. Maybe I could show you some of those. I could probably do that. But where is it? Did I save it in the wrong? Oh, here it is. Okay. Yeah, I did. I did save it in the wrong place. Sorry. Okay. Sorry. I'm just like trying to figure out the best way to do this. I guess this will be fine. I'm sorry that I'm doing this, like, annoying. There, okay. So, if I go here, there, okay. Alright, so, I'll show you some merch. This merch is coming out October 21st. You're going to hear a lot more about it once this single comes out on... Friday. After Friday, then I can start promoting the merch, you know? Okay, so this first one is the, I don't know what the name of this one is, but it's a red shirt. front and back, designed by Liver Ideas. You want me to zoom in? Well, okay. Yeah, I guess I can do that. There we go. And it's Tinseltown. I think this one's called like the Dark and Divine t-shirt. If you see kind of like underneath the black square on the front of the shirt, it says Dark and Divine. It's just like wrinkled a little bit. This is designed by Liver Ideas, who's incredible. Really incredible. It's red. This is red. Yeah, this is red. Dark and Divine t-shirt designed by Liver Ideas. Really nice. I think I'm going to have him do my album artwork too. What color red? Like just red. Full of love, full of pain, full of love. These are lyrics from The Moon Does Not. The moon does reflect off the shores of forgiveness. Love. Yeah, I guess that'll make more sense once the song comes out. Okay, next one. How do I do this? Escape My Grave hoodie. Purple. designed by Brianna Collins. I'm on the front, Ruby. That was me on the front. In purple. Exciting stuff, right? These ones are kind of limited because I wasn't super... You want me to zoom in? Yeah. I'll just zoom in. There. You see? There we go. It says, I am Wiccaphase. I can escape my grave anytime I want. This is designed by Brianna Collins. We've done these in black, white. What else? Green? Oh, and red. Yes. It's very nice. Okay, this is in purple. Yeah. It's back. It's back in purple. It's really nice. Okay. Next one. What do we have? Oh, okay. So this is the front of a hoodie. I won't spend too much time on this because it's just the GBC logo. There. Now this color. Okay, this color is a little tricky. It shows up a lot in this drop. It's like a reddish orange. But also these are like film photos taken at night under like weird lighting. So it might not be the best representation. But anyway, that's the front. This is the back. Okay, I'll zoom in. This is another design by Liver Ideas. Printed on really nice heavyweight hoodies. Yeah, so this is the back of the back of the one that says GBC on the front. If you hate red, don't worry. Because that's about all the red in there. Here is the same design on a... This is not a white t-shirt. This is a tan t-shirt. The first tan Wiccaphase Prince Eternal t-shirt. These are lyrics from Tracer. This will be... This is not a white shirt. Isaiah. This is in tan, like a light tan. And this will be a Discord exclusive shirt, okay? So you can only get this in the Discord. As we get closer to the drop, I will explain how you can do that. Now you can join the Discord here. It's free. There's no, you know, whatever. There's no barrier to entry. Yes, Noel, there will be pictures of all the merch uploaded later. Thanks, Smarty. Yeah, this is just a quick preview for you people. Residents of the Full Moon Mystery Garden. So yeah, join the Discord if you want this shirt, okay? The middle says, I saw the bird arrive, which are lyrics from the song Tracer that's out. What do I say? I say, I saw the bird arrive, Bonnie Bird Arise. Yeah, I saw the bird arrive, Bonnie Bird Arise. Mm-hmm. See me near the pillar in the back. Ooh, thanks, Ravager. Full Moon Mystery Garden. Okay, next one. Sorry, again, I'm doing this on the fly. Bedford Towers just sent me these pictures. And I just, like, grabbed a few of them that had, like, one of each design. Okay, next one. This is the craziest shirt. Okay. This is by far the craziest shirt. This is the, yeah, this is, also another Tracer lyric, right? Is the magic that I'm doing pure, serving me and only me inherently? Yeah, it's from Tracer. This is like a crazy EDM shirt. I don't even know. It was too crazy not to print. This is another Liver Ideas one. Again, Liver Ideas on Instagram. I don't have like a good shot of the shirt handy. Actually, maybe I have a mock-up. I don't want to be searching around on my computer. Well, hold on. Let me see if I can find one. This is the Pure Magic one. Yeah, it looks like this. There. Sorry, this is like the ugliest like visual representation of the merch, but that's what it... That's like more of what it'll look like. You can see here the sewn in tag. These will all have, all of this merch will have Wicked Face Prince Eternal tags. And I'm not going to fuck with you and like sell you Gildan, you know, $3 shirts. Make it seem like I made them, okay? The sizes, the weights of the shirts, the dimensions, everything will be available in the store. Okay. All right. Next. Oh, that's the back of it. This one. For the people who don't like red. A blue shirt. Stone Cold Sprint Eternal. Is designed by Jonah. Jonah designed this one. Yes, it's very nice. Simple, black, cold-looking t-shirt. In case you want a shirt with a skeleton's head on it that says Wicked Face Prince Eternal. Monkey says, any sort of bulk deals here? Yes. I will do some sort of Twitch/Discord collection. Some sort of, I'll help you out somehow. And you won't have to buy everything. You know how it is. You know, maybe it'll be for subscribers or something. I don't really know, but I'll help you out with it. Okay. Yes, these all drop on the same day. Now, let me tell you, the point of this is to have a lot of stuff in stock, just so we can, you know, I love having stuff sold out, but I also love having a store that people can always come to and buy stuff. So not only do we have a lot of items, but we also have a good amount of them. Or at least the ones I think will sell the most. Or like aren't super risky. You know, like the purple Escape My Grave hoodies are a little risky because not everyone wants to buy a purple hoodie. And some people might already have that, you know, in a couple different colors already. So I didn't get as many of those. But like this black t-shirt, I got a good amount because... you know, it's like a simple black t-shirt, you know? Now, Muffler, a lot of people do want purple hoodies. And a lot of these merch selections are based on responses from the merch survey that we did earlier this year. Any sweatpants? Not in this drop. Let's see, is there anything else? Oh, yeah, last one. This is just another cool looking black t-shirt, again by Liver Ideas. His real name is Jason Wright. No, this is so Monkey, this is my drop. Copes just works for me. Works with, well, how do I explain this? Copes has come on board Team Wiccaphase to help me grow, you know, just to just help me step up the merch stuff, you know? I can only, like, keep doing t-shirts and sweatshirts for so long, you know? Copes is really good at figuring out, you know, what we should do with what and accessories and other stuff, you know? Yes, this is just another cool black t-shirt. I love this design. I've never done colors like this. The yellow, the green, and the pink look really nice together. Yeah, this is the, what is this called? Oh, I can't, hold on. I can't be pulling up my finder. Despair t-shirt? Yeah. Okay, and that might be it. I think that's it. That's it. Okay. So, no, there is more. There's more. The socks will be a part of this drop. The skateboards will be a part of this drop. There's a new sticker bundle. Socks are at the warehouse now. Yeah, there's more. Skateboards will be a part of that. Socks will be a part of it. And then there's sticker bundle and one other thing that I can't reveal yet because I don't have pictures. It's going to be good, okay? It's going to be good. These will come out October 21st, 10 days from now. Yeah, reality. They, the socks did get sent out. Well, they probably got sent out, probably last Friday. Normally, like, I'll just send Dark Medicine my comps, like, stuff I want to send people to. And then all that stuff goes out, like, once a month, you know? I think we're off the medical records duty, at least for now. Anyway, thank you. That's part of the drop. October 21st. Thanks, Rose. Thanks, Ruby. I don't know how the boost is still in progress. I don't know how Twitch works. Did I see someone broke their back at TwitchCon jumping into a foam pit that wasn't padded enough? And Stinseltown. Estimate on time, 3 p.m. Eastern. Yeah, it was like a foam pit that was just like not deep enough. Yeah, someone broke their leg on it too. I saw a bunch of pictures of Fred. I didn't see any pictures of Fred jumping in the foam pit. Oh, man. Poor girl. All right, let's go over the schedule one more time. This Friday, the moon does reflect off the shores of forgiveness. Hey, I'm going to Darby Allin's house on Friday. Well, I'm flying down Friday. Come back Sunday. So on Sunday, I'll talk about my weekend at Darby's. Am I disappointed that I'm missing out on the big GBC show in Berkeley with Horsehead, Fish and Arc, and Doves? Yes. Yes, I am. The LA one, too, with MacNed. And the Doves one. The LA one is with MacNed and Doves, right? Yeah, I'm bummed about that. Yeah, I'm bummed. What's up, Enamored? Enamored, we're about to start. I'm going to answer some questions from the open forum. So if you have anything you want to ask anonymously, you can do it here. Is this the house he jumped over in a Jeep? I don't know. I don't know. I think it's like a nice house in Georgia. But yeah, I'm going there. I have no idea. No idea what is going on. I know it's like part of some party that Zoomies is throwing. Frank. Yeah, Zoomies is throwing a party at Darby's house or something because they have like a shared clothing line. I don't know. I know that there's a skate contest. And that's all I really... And then I'm performing. He just sent me a screenshot of a plane ticket. I don't know what's going on. Frank, you're fine, man. You're fine. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, we'll see how it goes. Thanks, Jordan. Thank you. Is Zoomies paying you big bucks? I don't know. Listen, I don't know the details of this, okay? I went through my booking people. The real reason I'm doing it is because Darby asked me to do, like, all this stuff all the time, and it's never logistically possible or, you know, like, it would require me to like buy a plane ticket and get a hotel and like do all, you know, they're just like money losers. You know what I mean? Like I could, you know, so, we were able to make this one work. So on Sunday, I'll talk about that. All right. So one more time. This Friday, the moon does reflect off the shores of forgiveness. Next Friday, merch drop. Big one. Friday after that? I'm sorry. Next Friday, merch drop. The Sunday after that, October 23rd. 1 year stream anniversary. I have some ideas. I think it's going to be a long one. I got to make a flyer for all this stuff. Oh, you're fine, Ruby. I have some ideas for the stream anniversary. Here's what I'm thinking. Don't know how much... I can do regarding a live performance, but maybe I can do something on some sort of delay where my fear is if I try and do a live performance, one, it's going to sound terrible. Two, it's going to blow up the thing, my whole setup here. The same way, like when I plug in Ableton, my microphone goes insane. So maybe some sort of like secret set. VDR, you're fine, man. You're fine. You're here now. I'm just getting good at it. There will be prizes. There will be giveaways. I'm going to try and get some guests on. I do need a streaming PC, Ravinger. That is what I need. I'll try and get some guests on. I'll try and do some sort of secret set. And then I'm thinking we close it out with like another DJ set. Like just a fun, you know, I don't know, like a fun, less of a theme and more, you know, I don't know. How long will the stream be? I don't know. Yeah, extra long. 4 hours, 3 hours, maybe? I don't know. I don't know, but I want to do something cool. Noel, this would be October 23rd, a Sunday. October 23rd. I'll make a flyer. I'm going to make a flyer for all this stuff that I have going on. That's October 23rd. Then there's a break between October 23rd and November 4th when the mixtape comes out. And in that period, you know, I'll reveal the track listing and some other stuff. I think that's my plan. Open forum. I just typed in the command for open forum. If you guys have anonymous or any questions, just send them there. But they are anonymous, so if you know, whatever. Do you guys watch House of the Dragon? Tinseltown, I don't think I watched much of the Fight Forever event, to be honest. It seemed grim to me. House of the Dragon, I've been into it. Every time I start going into it early on with that show, I was like, oh, this is going to be such a chore. And then like the show starts and I'm so into it and I can't believe it. I don't know any, I'm so bad at names. And I feel like they deliberately make it confusing. Aemond, Aegon. I won't do spoilers. But I'm curious to get a gauge as to how many people here watch it. I have not watched the Rings of Power show. Lelio, do you also watch House of the Dragon? Or did you choose Rings of Power over House of the Dragons? Shameless. I don't know. I would do a shake, I think. I mean, I would do both, but. What do you think are decent ways to get into creating music if you haven't been in touch with it besides listening a lot? Think about what kind of music you want to make and then go on YouTube and, I got you, Lelio. Sorry, to answer that question, I mean, think about what kind of music you want to make and then watch a bunch of YouTube videos. It's like how to do it, and then you'll get there. All right, open forum. Ooh, there's a lot. Okay. Would you say 30 plus is too late to start a music career? No. Also wouldn't worry about a career, you know? Do you make music already? Because before you have a career in making music, you have to get good at making music, you know? Or not good. I'm not saying I'm good at it, but you know what I mean? Yeah. Your music got me through some dark times and continues to do so. So thank you for sharing your art with the world. Well, thank you. I appreciate that. Thank you. Will I ever do a Chicago show? Yes, of course I will. I love playing in Chicago. And I would say that of all the places, of all the... You know, when I posted about the tour, it was Chicago that seemed to feel the most neglected, and I understand that. I'll be there. Thoughts on the baby hippo Fritz at the Cincinnati Zoo? He's so cute. I gotta see this hippo. Yeah, this guy's cool. He's cool. You guys know this guy? That guy's cool. I like him. He's cool. All right. Good question. All right, I'm gonna get out of here. From the bottom of all of our hearts, thank you for everything that you do. Did you guys write me? Did all 91 of you write me collectively to say that? No, thank you. I appreciate that. Are you friends with all of GBC still? Yes, of course. Do you sell features or do you only collab with artists UFW? I only collab with artists IFW. That's pretty much true. Skincare routine is bare minimum. A little bit of some moisturizer, if I remember. Sometimes some eye, under eye stuff, if I remember. Person says your favorite. I think they forgot to specify. Do I fuck with bears? Yeah, I do. I'm sticking to questions in the open forum, but yeah, I do. This person says been watching you for years now. Proud of you, my boy. Well, thank you. I appreciate that. Top three dream collaborations. Let's see. Who are my top three? Phil Elverum. Bonnie Prince Billy. Daft Punk. I feel like I could do something cool with them. Yeah, Grouper. Noel, you're right. Grouper. Grouper would be a great one. Grouper's probably up there. I would say that one of my dream collaborations is on the Run for Cover LP that's coming out in May. And it wasn't like... It was just something that like I thought... just like didn't think it would happen, so I didn't ever like, you know, whatever. But then when it came together, I was like, wow, that is a dream collaboration for me. Possibly Noel. Is the Stizza collaboration real or is that some BS I read online? No, it's No. Phil Mount Erie's real name is Phil Elverum. That's who we're talking about. The Stizza collaboration was attempted, but then he never sent me the files for the song. Like, he sent me the song back, but it needed to be... It was just like a demo, like a rough demo thing. And then he never sent me the files. So Brody took his place on the song, which is pretty funny. I also sent it to someone else and she never sent it back, but I don't want to, maybe that'll happen in the future. So I don't want to, you know. Hey Adam, soothing activities for hard times, things that get you out of bad headspaces, mood lifters. I like going to the gym helps me, like any sort of exercise, like work, like, or walking. I'm sorry. Walking helps. What else helps me? Playing video games helps sometimes. Accomplishing anything helps me. You know what I mean? Like doing anything, checking something off my list, or like staying active. That's, you know, that. Or like just indulging in like positive, how can I say this? All right, like a lot of times I think of like Nintendo games, like Mario games are like, okay, there's nothing too heavy about those. They're like just fun, like colorful, bright, bouncy games, like that helps sometimes, you know, stuff like that. Yeah, people say Animal Crossing. I never played Animal Crossing, but yeah, there you go. I've never played Stardew Valley either. Pokemon I play. Yeah, I play Red Dead. That's about it. Were you ever friends with KillStation? No, I only met him once, I think. Once or twice in Europe. In Paris. I was playing a show in Paris and he was there. What are your top five favorite wrestling matches of the year so far? Ooh boy. I'm pretty bad with this stuff. I'll go to cage match. How about that? Did he sample me? I don't. I don't know. I don't think I did a song with KillStation. As far as I remember, I don't know. All right, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go to cage match. I'm going to go to the match guide. And I'm going to look to see what people have rated the highest this year, and I'll see which one, if any of them jump out to me. I can't recall stuff. I'm so bad, especially when it comes to wrestling. Like when it comes to like making year-end lists for wrestling, this is exactly what I'll do, and then I'll go back and watch everything that's like notable and then pick my list. All right. Right now, FTR and Aussie Open is the number one ranked match of the year based on fan votes on Cage Match. That's crazy. It only has 51, but the average is so high. All right. Adam Page versus Bryan Danielson. That's up there for me. I need to watch that El Desperado June Kasai match. The first FTR versus Briscoes might be up there for me. That's Tinseltown. Ooh, that Bryan Danielson Daniel Garcia match is up there. Yeah, Claudio Castagnoli against Kinosuke Takeshita is up there. And one more. I don't know. Danielson. Danielson had one recently that I thought was really awesome. What was that? I don't know. Those are some of mine. Maybe Okada against Ospreay from the G1 finals. Maybe that. Maybe Will versus Will Ospreay versus Zach from G1. That's up there. Let's listen to this song, Noel. I think that is a sample, a Tiger's Jaw acoustic sample. But I don't know if I played on that song. From Hum? Maybe I did. I don't know. When you are finished with the new... When you are finished with the new Garden Avenue tape, or any new release for that matter, do you have your girlfriend listen to it and give her a seal of approval? As a writer, sometimes I find it uncomfortable to let my spouse see my work and think that they might not have enjoyed it or found it lacking. No, I don't. No. It's like too weird, you know? I don't know. I don't like date based on. No, I understand the question, but I don't do that. And I can't really explain why. Is Horsehead officially Goth Boy Click? Yes. How long did it take to get used to the technical side of Twitch? One year and counting. I'm still not great at it. I would say like a couple months into it. When I came back in January, I felt like pretty comfortable. But I'm still getting used to it. I'm doing the bare minimum, I feel like, for the most part, you know? Once I get calls on here, I'll be unstoppable. And a ring light. I did see that Tiger Shaw's playing when we were young. I hope they're getting paid $40,000 for that. You got your music got me through some dark times. I'm sure a lot of people say that, but it's true. Thank you. Do you eat meat? Yes. Sometimes I feel bad about eating meat, but I just don't feel right without it. Eat meat. You can do other things. If it's an ethical thing, or, you know, whatever. No, I'm not going to go see them, Ruby. It's in Las Vegas, and, you know. I'm so indifferent about Blink-182. I used to love Blink-182. I guess there's a part of me that still does, but I'm indifferent on the reunion. What is your favorite fantasy camp track? Ooh, that is a good one. I feel like I've answered this before, and I feel like I'm going to give a different different answer now. I like Bug Bite. I like Quicksand. I love Black Metal Long Sleeve with Paper Rose Haiku. I like Water on Your Skin. I like Never Met. What's the one that's like, is it called Stay? Is the name of it Stay? Stay With Me? What's the name of that song? I forget. Anyway, those are some of my favorites. Do you have your own warehouse for merch? Yes. Do you ever get annoyed with the GBC subreddit? Sometimes, but not always. What's your least hated airline? I don't know, like Delta maybe, or Southwest. I don't know. What audio interface do you record vocals with? The Apollo Twin. What is the current GBC roster? Wickedface, Prince Eternal, JP Dream Thug, Coldheart, Horsehead, MacNed, Doves, Fishnark, Yawns, Lil Tracy, I think, and Lil Peep. Would you ever consider playing in Vermont? Yes. Other rap names in the past? Bloodman. How GBC dealt so well with all the defamation after Peep passed away? I don't know. I don't know if that implies that we did deal with it well. I don't know. Norwegian is pretty good. How, would you do covers as Wickedface, Springs Eternal, or Adam Mackley? Have you covered anyone? I can't recall. All my music is under the Wickedface. All my music is under the Wickedface name now. I kind of like that idea. I'm comfortable with it, and I like that I feel comfortable enough to do whatever I want under this name. I did cover Country Roads, but that was a birthday present for Copes. This person says, also, shout out for being a longtime Twitter mutual with me. Been a fan since the beginning days. Well, I appreciate that. Do you watch any sports or are fans of any particular teams? All right, here's what's up. I'll watch any sports. Baseball is my favorite. And I like watching football, but I'm not, like, I don't follow any teams or anything like that. I just get into anything, like any sports, if I'm watching them. You know what I mean? I don't watch golf, but I bet if I had the patience for it, I could get into it. You know? I used to play golf a lot when I was younger. I'll go with my aunt. But like right now the baseball playoffs are on, and I'm really excited about them, and I've been watching them, but I don't like root for anyone in particular. I just like hope to be entertained by a good game, you know? Have I ever formally met Phil Elverum? Yeah, one time Tiger's Jaw played a show with him. Tiger's Jaw got their name from a Phil Elverum song, and I went up to him and I said, I'm a big fan and we named our band after you. And he said, I thought that sounded familiar. And that was it. And then right as he was about to go on, a girl had a seizure in the crowd. Ended up being fine. And he was just like, it's fine. No one needs to freak out. It was a pretty crazy experience. I was at Redwood Art Space. Not considering 2000s Noah sport. Listen, I mean, I watch a lot of UFC. I'll watch any sort of MMA, any sort of Muay Thai, even amateur wrestling or catch wrestling. I'll watch. Who are your favorite artists to work with? In what ways and terms? What is the secret to make a sad beat, in your opinion? All right, the secret to making a sad beat is it all. Just like how do I say this? You want to, you want the minor chords to hit in the right place. I don't know. It's all about where you put the minor chords, but you don't need a minor chord either. You can make a sad song without it. Sometimes having a song with all major chords but with sad lyrics can make the song even sadder. But normally I think it's like if you hinge the song around a minor chord that's placed in the right spot. Here, like, all right. What's that song? Me and Jonah. I think Jonah turned me onto this song. It's Bonnie Raitt song. And I'll... Let's listen to it. This song. Here, I'll show you. I'll show you where. I'll show you what exactly what makes this song sad, aside from the lyrics. Okay. All right. Hold on. Let's start this over. Things out of control. Right now, it can go either way.
Turn down the light.
That second chord being a minor chord. That's one way to do it, because you're starting with something major and automatically going into something minor, so you're telling people this is going to be dark or sad. That helps.
Turn down the bed. Turn down these voices inside my head.
Here's the chorus.
Cause I can make you love me if you don't. You can make your heart feel something it won't. Here in the dark, in these final hours, I will.
I'll link to that in case you guys. It's a kind of a long song. There. All right. So like that's an example of a song where like there is the introduction. No, I don't think I ever played that as an outro song. I don't think so. I haven't thought about the song in a while. It was just like the saddest song that I could think of off the top of my head. There is a minor. You do have like the move. Starting from a major to a minor, but then it doesn't like resolve on a minor. The chords are pretty major throughout, C, G, F, or whatever key it's in. But they're like, I don't know. It's just a feeling, you know? I think I know how we can recover. There, we'll cleanse ourselves. All right, I'll do a couple more, and then I have to get out of here. All right, my favorite artists to work with are Doves, Darcy, Fishnark, usually it's people that can handle like that are good songwriters that are also better than me at handling the technical side of music. Does that make sense? Like Ben Walsh is like an amazing guitar. He's amazing at every instrument that he plays. And he's a great songwriter. So working with him is great because he picks up the slack on the stuff that I'm not so good at and also brings his own, you know, songwriting skills to the table. Darcy is the same way. Darcy specific and Doves, both of them, I think what makes them so great is that they're technically gifted, they're great songwriters, and their tastes are incredible. So I like learn a lot about like what is cool. I learn like a lot of cool stuff about them, like from them, you know. You know, that's some. How's their Cold Heart EP with Yawns producing coming along? It's not coming along. It hasn't been talked about at all. I think Doves Cry Springs Eternal 2 is more likely. Do you ever read the open forum submissions outside of streams for funsies? Yeah, sometimes I do. What brand of saltwater spray do you use for your hair? I think it's pronounced Way. It's O-U-A-I. Oh, that was you, Shameless? Yeah. O-U-A-I. Way. Winterphase X Alien Body again. When? I don't know. It's the door is open. Possibilities of a new feature with Ghost. I don't know how to get in touch with Ghost, but I'd be down. Is Hellversion up somewhere? And if not, will it ever be? I think it's on Bandcamp. Right? Yeah, it is. Do any of the songs from Full Moon Mystery Garden have quotes / bars or harmonies from the new album? Yeah, there's like one. One where I say like something still remorseful, open portal. And I think I say that on the new album too. Did you ever play sports? Yeah, I played like baseball when I was young, like up through little league, or maybe like teener league or whatever. Oh, if this person meant Ghost Main, I don't know. I don't know. Yeah, I played baseball, I played soccer, I played basketball, I wrestled in middle school. No, not that person, Shameless. No, old ghost from early.
Thank you.